Hi, this is Matthew Robert Payne. This is a t-shirt I designed, Imagine a World Without Greed, for 200 t-shirts. And if you're tuned in to this, watching this prophecy, you can not only request a prophecy in the description tag on my website down below, but you can order one of my 200 t-shirts or a hoodie, jumper, you know, sweat top for your own needs. Hi Antonio, Antonio, sorry for name pronunciation not right. When I thought of you getting ready for this prophecy, I just felt this rush of joy and a sense that Jesus and the Holy Spirit and the Father really love you. Get the opinion of them, get a sense of them that you're really a people's person, that you're really a person who lays down his life for other people, a person who willingly serves. I sense there's a verse in Revelation that says, I know you of little strength, but you've not denied my name. And I get a sense that you mightn't be the best educated, you mightn't have the most money, you mightn't have all the right contacts and the people and the businesses and the finance to be someone great and to be someone really successful. But I sense that you're like the little boy with the two loaves, two fish and the five loaves, that you only have a little bit, but you give all that you have for the kingdom of God. And I sense that Jesus, and especially Jesus, is really appreciative, very happy and full of joy with you. I sense as I speak that you've had some trials, that you've had some hard times. You've had at least five times where you thought of going back into the world and going back into drugs or alcohol and walking away from the Lord. I sense that it's as though you've got a prophetic walk. It's as though you've got a calling to be a prophet. And if you want to learn more about the prophetic, I've got five books under Matthew Robert Payne on the prophetic. And I sense that you've almost got a prophetic call. I'd say that you have got one. And life has been tough. Life has been hard for you to handle and experience. And I sense that it's during these hard times, it's during this testing, it's during this sifting that the Lord allows you to have, that develops such a strong and abiding character. I sense that you've really developed this character that is, the word coming to me is resilient, is like Teflon. Teflon, the meat doesn't stick to Teflon, it just slides off. And I sense that you've got like this Teflon sort of character that you can have insults and trials and struggles and they just slide off you. And it's not as though you don't experience the trial or the heartache or the problem, but I sense that and the Lord has developed like a wonderful, resilient, patient, kind sort of character in you. I sense that in some aspects you're going to teach, a sense in some ways you're going to reach people with preaching. I can see books in you. I can see interviews on Sid Roth and Jim Baker if they exist in times to come. I can see you writing some good books. I can see you preaching at conferences. I can see you doing all sorts of wonderful things in the future. One caution that I have for you is And the enemy will test you on this, and so I'll share it with you. He's after pride in your life. He's after, as you get promoted and get these experiences to be on TV and preach at conferences, he wants to puff you up with pride. He wants to make you think that you're better than the average Christian, that you're more esteemed, you've got better revelation, and you've got greater skills and gifts and abilities. And that may be true, but if you walk away unthinking that way, it can cause you trouble, and certainly caused me trouble. So I sense that that you have this character like the Apostle Paul, that Paul, I considered himself the least and the servant of all. And Jesus said, anyone who wants to become great must become the world's best servant. And Jesus certainly demonstrated that, and so did the Apostle Paul. And I feel that you practically, with your life, live a life that demonstrates that. And I see a checkbook. I've got a checkbook here. I see a checkbook open with signatures in it, and it's like the Lord has made an open checkbook for you. And I think I've seen that a couple of times in people's prophecies over the years. But it then says an unlimited amount of money that will be provided to you for you to properly minister to people. And the Holy Spirit tells me that you're a very good steward of your finances, and you're a very good steward of the Lord's money. And I sense that that the Lord is going to continue to give you prosperous ideas. I see entrepreneurship and business in you, and he's going to continue to prosper you through financial means, so that you can grow in your ministry and spread your ministry, and have more money to provide a better ministry and have a greater reach. And I sense that you've been tried and sifted in many areas, and I sense from the Holy Spirit that you've been passed, and you've achieved what the Lord wanted you to achieve, and you've been tested and tried, and you've come forth as gold. And I know that I would love to hear that I've come forth as gold. You've been tried and tested and come forth as gold. And I sense that because you're such a servant and willing and obedient son of God, that God can really glorify his name through you. He can build his name and glorify his name through you. What is it? Hello, who is it? Who is at the door? And sorry, I had a knock at the door. So I sense that you've really developed this beautiful personality that can be trusted by the Lord. And when I saw that open check, it's as though you got dreams and desires. You got things that you want to do with your life for the Lord. And I sense Ephesians 3:20 is going to apply to you, that you're going to do exceedingly abundantly, more than you ask or think. You're going to really perform at a really terrific way and really a terrific level. And you're really going to demonstrate God's power. He's going to glorify his own name through you. He's going to glorify your name too. So I pray that this has blessed you and encouraged you. And thank you once again for waiting for so long for this prophecy. I've been in hospital for 2 weeks, and it's good to deliver a prophecy finally. And thank you for waiting. God bless.